presentation called Safe from Blows, and it is taken from Ephesians 6, verse 11. And Benjamin, if you could read that for us, that would get us started. The whole armor of God. Now, we're going to move over to our special chair. I need a victim to sit in the chair. And the victim's chair is Ashley. And what you need for this science demonstration is a hammer and a nail. Because I'm going to pretend I'm Satan. And I'm coming after Ashley with a hammer and a nail to try to nail her. And what I need for her to do is to hold this book on her head. You have to take your hands, because I'm letting go. And then this 2x4 goes on top of it. And is it all right with you, Ashley, if I hammer a nail into the 2x4, do you think it's going to hurt you or bother you?
Probably bother me.
Okay, well, here's a trusty hammer, and I hope I don't miss. But I'll do my very best not to miss. And I'm going to hammer this nail into this 2x4. But you don't have to grimace. I love you. Remember, I love you. But this book that we have in between the 2x4 and her head is like the armor of God. And so we're just going to see if this is going to hurt her head. What do you think? Ready? I'm ready, Ashley. I've been wanting to do this for a long time, and now I have a reason. Here we go. Oh dear, you're squinching down. Stand up straight. You've got the armor of God on. Sit up straight. Here we go. How does that feel?
It hurts my head.
No. Wait a minute. You have a tender head. Try to be tough, because here comes some more. Okay, we'll stop there for now. I don't know. Are you all right? Okay, there are some people who put bricks on their chest. Maybe you've seen them on YouTube or somewhere else. And they can break those bricks without hurting the person underneath. There's a way to do that. And if we had a larger book, they said to use a soft covered book. But if it were larger, it would displace some of the force that's going down on your head easier. Now, Satan comes after us with a huge hammer and a huge nail, trying to tempt us, trying to get us to do what's wrong, trying to harm us. And if we didn't have the armor of God, we would be harmed. Now, let's go over to the next slide. Thank you very much. Over there, Ashley, you can come with us, because in Ephesians it tells us more about what some of this armor is. Slide number 3 talks about truth. I've listed truth and righteousness, peace and faith, salvation, the Word of God. Even prayer and watchfulness are mentioned in this section in Ephesians. But what is the part that protects our head? Do you know? What is
the helmet of salvation?
That's right. And so, the larger helmet you have and the sturdier helmet you have is what will protect you the most. That helmet of salvation, Ashley, you need a good, strong helmet, because Satan is after your mind and he's after my mind. And it doesn't matter how big the stakes, how heavy the hammer, if we have the helmet of salvation as well as the rest of the armor of God, we will be safe. And God will take all the blows for us. We don't have to be harmed at all. Okay, thank you very much. That's the end of our science demonstration.